Talk to this Gunho Kiyotaka Ishimaru. See, now they're gonna make us remember all the conversations that we ever had. I'm gonna have to like get a notepad or something and just take notes. God damn it.
I'm Kiyotaka Ishimaru. I believe in bold simplicity. Let's work together on our educational crusade.
Is this guy an officer or is he just very, very gung-ho about being like a hall monitor? Kiyotaka Ishimaru, ultimate moral compass. Oh. So that's Kiyotaka. According to what I saw about him on a thread, he went to a famous privileged school and won top honors every year. He's basically a flawless honor student. He's also known for the work he's done with his community's public moral committee. Let's say he respects the rules above all else, earning him the title of ultimate moral compass. Anyway, you can call me Taka. You said your name was Makoto Naegi, right? That's a good name, a strong name. You should thank your parents for giving you such an excellent name.
You hear me?
Okay, he's so intense about everything. To keep the name from losing its value, you must devote yourself every single day.
Got it!
Life is worth putting every ounce of effort into it. Right? Right? Kiyotaka. Got it. Gonna have to start remembering all the names. This guy's kind of annoying. It is. A little bit. Kiyotaka. Okay, Kiyotaka the General. We got Toko. Looks like she's pretty shy.
You'll remember my name anyway, but...
Can you speak up a little?
I'm Toko. Toko Fukawa.
Toko Fukawa. Toko Fukawa, ultimate writing prodigy. Yeah, she wrote a novel when she was 10 that got everyone talking and launched her literary career. Then 2 years later ago, and 2 years ago she released So Lingers the Ocean, a love story said to be her masterpiece. The book was such a hit that with women that fishermen quickly shot to the top of every hottest man pole. Damn. Despite her age, she won countless literary prizes and all her books are instant bestsellers, which is why she's come to be known as the ultimate writing prodigy. What else would you call such a young and talented author? But I figured she'd be a lovey-dovey type, what with her masterpiece being on romance and all. Usually they're not. She seems to be very shy.
What's your problem?
What? It's not polite to stare, you know?
What the heck?
What the f- What's wrong with her? Stop staring at me like I'm some filthy creature. Relax. Filthy creature? No, I just thought... I know you just thought. You just thought you'd never seen such an ugly woman. You just thought it was so funny. What the hell is wrong with this girl? No, that's not what I was talking at all. Don't bother trying to lie to me. What the hell is wrong with her? I know it's true. Otherwise, I know you can't stand looking at me.
Anyway.
Whatever. I don't care. I'm used to it. Wow. Talk about inferiority complex. I was way off about what a successful author would be like. I guess they all are ultimate at something, but they all have their own flaws. Like he is way too gung ho about things. Way too gung ho in whether he is a moral compass. She is. Has inferiority complex, even though she's a famous author. What about you, Sayaka?
Hi, I'm Sayaka Maizona. I look forward to getting to know you.
I think that's the pop artist. Sayaka Maizona, ultimate pop sensation. Yeah, it is, ultimate pop sensation. The way she moves is positively mesmerizing. And a pleasant scent I can't quite place. Sayaka Maizona. When I saw her name in a thread online, frankly I was pretty surprised. She's in a pop group famous all across the country. In fact, she's the lead singer. As the ultimate pop sensation, she's in high demand to appear on TV and in magazines everywhere. But actually, that's not the only reason I was so surprised to find out she'd be going to this school. I'm sure she doesn't remember, but... Well, never mind. No matter how you slice it, she's really beautiful. Almost like a doll or something. Not a doll, you know. I'm alive. Huh? Did you hear me? I'm psychic. Really? What the hell? Huh? Kidding. I just have really good intuition. She's a sharp one.
Hey,
by any chance. Now what?
Huh?
Yeah, it must be. I'm sure of it. Hey, Makoto, did...
Just hold on!
Jeez, you guys. How would you plan to waste our valuable time with this ridiculous back and forth? Sorry, I got carried away, I guess. What was she gonna say?
You hear me?
Some introductions are for introduction yourself, not bumbling through a bunch of idle chit-chat. This guy needs to relax. Right.
Sorry.
Sorry, Makoto. We'll talk about this later. Sounds like Sayaka really had something she wanted to say. But it's not like we'll never see each other again. Like she said, we can talk later. We're definitely gonna talk to her. Sayaka. She's gonna be probably... I don't know what she was gonna tell us. She's gonna say something, but now I'm intrigued. So what do we got here? We got Kyotaka, we got Toko, we got Sayaka, Leon.
Yo, the name's Leon Kuwata. What's up?
Don't say he wants to beat the shit out of me. Leon Kuwata, ultimate baseball star. Oh, that's a baseball star. I recognize that name. He played for the National High School Champs as a cleanup hitter, the ultimate baseball star. That superb athletic specimen is... You? Seriously? Huh? What's wrong? Nothing, I'm just surprised. I figured you'd be the ultimate baseball star and all.
Give me a break.
What, are you expecting some kid with a shaved head? Shaved head? No, I would just expect more of a, you know, sporty looking traditional baseball player. I mean, when I found the article and picture of you online, that's how you looked then. What? Oh man, you found that picture of me playing baseball? Seriously? I hate that picture. That is not cool. That is so not cool. Seriously, I'm like mega embarrassed right now. I didn't have a choice, okay? Shaving your head like that is part of national championship regulations. But now I refuse to cut my hair, and I'm gonna dye it back to normal either. Alright. Actually, can I be totally honest with you?
You know,
I don't like baseball, like at all. I never gone to a single practice. He's no practice and he was still esteemed star player? He's some kind of prodigy.
Yeah!
Prodigy? Whatever. And as soon as I got accepted here, I quit baseball for good. I have my own dreams for the future. A dream? For the future? My only path in life is getting into music. You can feel that star quality aura I have, right? Not really.
You know what I mean.
I'm gonna be a singer, so all I need is a songwriter and someone on guitar, and we're set.
How cool is that?
This new version of me that's chasing after my dream is like super cool to the max. Can't believe what I'm hearing. I never imagined I'd hear something like that from a baseball at all. From baseball star, or I guess baseball all-star, that's what I was trying to say. There's a little button here, not sure what it means. And we got this guy over here, a hamster looking guy. Heifumi. I don't know why, but that thing seems fitting. So what do we got here? Let's do a quick recap. We got Kyotaka, which is where you can hold moral compass. We got Toko, which is the writer. We got Sayaka, which is a pop icon. We got Leon, who apparently is an accidental baseball prodigy. And now we got Heifumi.
I am Heifumi Yamada. But if you want to call me by my nickname,
the Alpha and the Omega.
I don't mind.
What? Heifumi Yamada, ultimate fanfic creator. Oh. This is a fanfic creator? Wow. Well, I know where all the fanfictions come from this guy. Everybody blame him for the fanfictions. And by the way, how much do you know about the world of 2D art? I'm playing a game of 2D art? World of 2D? Well, in that world, I'm well known and supremely well regarded as the ultimate fanfic creator. Mm-hmm. I once sold 10,000 copies of one of my fan comics at school festival. The event has passed into legend. Some of them didn't get it, of course, saying I tainted the event. How stupid can you be? I'm trying to give him like a nasally voice. That's too bad about them, but selling 10,000 copies like that is definitely pretty remarkable.
However,
the world of such idiots mean nothing to me. I'm like Van Gogh. Utterly unappreciated in my time. I'm a soldier, serving night and day to destroy all mindless preconceptions about fanfiction. I'm sure if you were to observe my work, Mr. Naegi, you would comprehend its greatness immediately.
Mm-hmm.
For my work is filled with deepest meanings. What kind of meanings?
Yes, indeed.
It's about embracing our basest urges. I don't think I want to comprehend it. Yeah, I don't think I want to comprehend it either. Oh god, now I... Heifumi, right? I think that was his name. Okay, now talk to the other 5 people over there. 15 people. I'm gonna have to learn all about these people? Oh my god, this is gonna be... How? This game is gonna drive me mad just trying to memorize all the personalities and all the people. Jesus Christ. I guess we can talk to Aoi then. Aoi Asahina.
Heya! I'm Aoi Asahina. But my friends just call me Hina. Sup?
Or Aoi. Aoi Asahina. Asahina is from... Remember that was a... She's a swimming pro, okay. Asahina, it's gonna be easy to remember her because she has the same last name as the character from Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya. So that's gonna be sort of easy to remember, I don't know. Aoi Asahina, she's been breaking records in every competition she's been in since elementary school. She's even been chosen to an upcoming Olympic cadet, or as an upcoming Olympic cadet. She is without a doubt the ultimate swimming pro. The combination of her ability, appearance, and proportions have been widely discussed online. So, what's your name again? Sorry, totally forgot. Makoto Naegi. Oh yeah, I knew it was something like that. No, not something like that. It is that.
You got it!
Sure, got it. Here, I'll hammer it into my brain right now.
Yeah.
Makoto Naegi. She's keep repeating my name and moving her fingers across her palm like she was writing something. What are you doing?
Huh?
You don't know? If you want to remember someone's name, you gotta write it on your hand 3 times. Never heard of that before in my life. Really? Is that gonna work? I'm trying it. I'm actually legit trying it. We'll see if that works. We'll see if I remember this girl's name. Hey, by the way, how do you spell your last name? You spell exactly how like it sounds. Well, I have no idea. I'll figure it out later and write it down. Anyway, glad to meet you. Sure, same here. Well, one thing I learned is she's totally easygoing and bursting with energy. Well, good for her. We got Chihiro Fujisaki.
Hello, nice to meet you. I'm Chihiro Fujisaki.
She seems pretty normal. Chihiro Fujisaki, ultimate programmer. Oh, she's the programmer. I might get along personally better with her because I'm into IT and it's not that far from programming, so maybe I'll understand her better. I get kind of embarrassed when I introduce myself like this. Anyway, I hope we can get along. Same here, nice to meet you.
Huh?
Huh? Maybe it's just my imagination, but have we met before? I don't think so. We just met for the first time, which is why I said nice to meet you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, good point. Sorry. You don't have to apologize for that.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Chihiro Fujisaki is known for all the cutting-edge programs she created. She's the ultimate programmer. She also got the timid little bunny-type thing going, which has earned her to her legion of fans. So listen.
I'm sorry.
Huh? What are you apologizing for? Just cause you seem upset. You must be mad at me, right? What is wrong with her? No, not at all. I was just lost in thought about something.
Huh?
Lost in thought? God, she looks like she's about to cry. Yeah, it had nothing to do with me being upset or anything.
Thank you.
Oh, that's good. That's good. I was afraid maybe you didn't like me. I'm glad. What should be like the weird, evil, complete opposite type, like on the inside? I'm starting to understand why her fans are so into her. Yeah, definitely. What do we got here? Kyoko Kirigiri. Kirigiri is gonna be hard to not remember. Guess let's talk to Kirigiri here. Kyoko. She's not saying anything. Can I ask your name?
My name is Kyoko Kirigiri.
Ultimate something something something? Kyoko Kirigiri. She's pretty tight-lipped, huh? Oh, but you know, her name didn't show up anywhere in that whole Speak Academy thread. I did see that there were students like me, ones that didn't have any real identity or presence. Could this girl be one of them? So what are you doing at the school?
What?
What's that supposed to mean? No, I just mean getting involved here, getting invited here means you have some kind of ultimate something, right? So what ultimate something are you?
That doesn't matter.
What should I tell you? Huh? Well, I guess you don't have to tell me. No, I don't have to tell you, so I'm not going to. Nothing about her turned up online, so I was thinking maybe she got picked by chance like me, but... Her face is like an iron mask. If she doesn't want to tell me anything, no point in asking. I'm gonna go ahead and brand her as Ultimate Mystery, because we don't know anything about her. Kyoko, the mystery, Chihiro, the programmer, Aoi, the swimmer. We got, Junko, that is, Junko the...
Hi! I'm Junko Enoshima. Charmed, I'm sure.
God, her mouth is really wide. Holy shit, that is demonic looking. Junko Enoshima, Ultimate Fashionista. Junko the Fashionista. God, that, look at that mouth, that is terrifying, that's scary looking. Anybody would recognize this one. Yeah, she's not smiling at any of those pictures, that's why... That's why her because her mouth is the scariest quality about her, which is why she doesn't smile. She got more charm or presence than any high school girl in the country. She's the ultimate fashionista. I've seen her on tons of magazine covers, but... I feel like that doesn't quite match up to reality.
What?
Huh?
Come on.
Oh, you talk about my cover photos and junk? Ah, well, of course. Those are totally photoshopped. Photoshopped? Yeah, you know, edited to hell and back. Like computers and junk? Oh, so they aren't real.
What can we do?
Come on, don't act so surprised. You're gonna make me all depressed.
Totally.
It's totally normal these days to photoshop the crap out of photo cover photos. If you're surprised by that, you'd totally be blown away by a certain dangerous little diva of ours. Make the eyes and junk super big and tweak the skin so it looks all ceramic and porcelain. Oh, so many dreams are getting crushed today. Many dreams are getting crushed today. Junko the fashionista. Mondo, the weird haircut guy, biker.
Name's Mondo Iwata. Nice to fucking meet you.
Alright then. Mondo Iwata, ultimate biker gang leader. Mondo Iwata, huh? Which means... He's the current leader of the largest biker gang in Japan. He earned respect, he's earned respect, even awe, from every gang in the country. He is the ultimate biker gang leader. Nice to meet you too.
Yo.
Hell yeah. I better be careful around him. One wrong word and I could wake up at the bottom of the sea. Yeah, we got the other two. Okay, the other four. I guess we are the 15th one. These four over there are the only ones left. What the hell? What? What is he wearing? What the actual fuck? What the hell? Oh my god. Okay, Sakura. Yeah, is that a dude or is that a girl? I cannot tell. Let's talk to Sakura then.
I am Sakura Ogami.
Is that a girl? Sakura Ogami, which means a martial artist. I mean, that explains the muscles. Oh jeez, almost asked if she was a guy. So that's a girl, confirmed. The day I say something like that out loud is the day I get turned to a human meatball. But now remember, she competed in a martial arts tournament in America and won, despite being a girl. She's the ultimate martial artist. She fought in over 400 matches and never lost a single one. The thread also said a bit more about her. Some call her Ogre. Some even think she's the closest known relative to the primates, the famed missing link. Damn. Any coming Hope's Peak students who are reading this, let me warn you right now. If you value life, avoid her at all cost. Standing in front of her now, I don't think they were exaggerating about that.
Hey.
You. Yes? Sent her attention without even realizing it, and she started to poke and prod at my body. What are you-
I see.
Muscle quality and quantity is right around of extreme ordinary high school student.
Hmm.
That's a girl? It's really hard to tell that's a girl, though, honestly. Hmm, what a shame. You're not all fit to act as my training partner. Not sure that's such a shame for me. Guess we'll avoid Sakura here. Jesus Christ. The missing link might be a proper response for that. What do we got here? Byakuya?
Name's Byakuya Togami.
Byakuya Togami, huh? Ultimate affluent progeny, Byakuya Togami. Huh? Nice to meet you. That's the most half-assed introduction I've ever heard. That isn't really anything I can do about it. Even among the ultimate students, this one is special. Byakuya Togami, he is the heir apparent of his family's massive financial conglomerate. He's also starting managing business operations. His own personal assets are, well, vast. His style of ultimate affluent progeny is completely accurate. He is the definition of exceptional. That's everything I learned about him from the Hope's Peak Academy thread online.
Come on.
We're done with introductions, right? How much longer are you going to stand there? Go away, I'm sick of looking at you. His aura says to me, you and I would never stand on the same level. Like a king in training. Damn, alright then. I got Yashihiro with whatever hair that he has over there. Okay, so let's recap. Sakura the martial artist, Byakuya the rich guy, Yashihiro, I don't know much about him, and Celeste. Oh, she does have a last name, thank god. It's gonna be a little bit easier to remember her, the girl without a last name. Yashihiro. Let's talk to him.
I'm Yasuhiro Hagakure. Hero for short. Take it easy, yeah? I know I will.
Yasuhiro, not Yashihiro, my bad. Yasuhiro Hagakure. Clairvoyant, huh? Hero Hagakure, known as a supernova in the psychic community. The trend-setting ultimate clairvoyant. Is psychic? Wow. Honestly, I don't really get all this fortune-telling stuff. It's pretty much beyond me. Still, I can't help wondering if there's any truth to it.
Could it be?
Okay, I give up. Huh? What's happening?
You're serious.
I saw it. I looked right at it. Seriously, I totally saw it. I should probably give him like a bro voice, like, bro, see what? A guardian angel with a crazy perm chasing after Bigfoot, running off with a skyfish in the mouth. The guardian angel is your guardian angel, bro. Nah, I'm just kidding. But hey, we should grab some brewski sometime and get real deep into Lemuria and its civilization. What? When else to drink? We're in high school.
You know?
Oh, I'm actually 21. I've been held back a few times, see? And, well, it's a long story. Wow. Few times? Yeah, I bet that is a long story. So we got Yasuhiro, the bro, and the clairvoyant. We got Byakuya, the progeny. Well, not a progeny, but a rich kid. Sakura, the martial artist, missing link, and then Celeste.
I do not think we have been introduced. I am Celestia Ludenberg.
A European, all right then. Celestia Ludenberg, ultimate gambler, ooh. Celestia Luden, huh? Ludenberg, it is my name. But if you don't mind, I would prefer for you to call me Celeste. You are Japanese, right?
Huh?
Of course. Why do you ask? If you don't mind, could you tell me your real name? I don't know what you're talking about. Celestia Ludenberg is my real name. But as I mentioned, I would much rather you call me Celeste. She's polite, but pretty forceful at the same time. I don't think she wants to say any more about it. I guess the rumors and the threat were right about her. The self-styled Celestia Ludenberg, she's the ultimate gambler who never lost a bet. Other than her obvious love of gothic Lolita clothes, everything about her is wrapped in a veil of lies. They say that she entered and won an underground gambling tournament, earning the title Queen of Liars. She totally cleaned out the other players, taking the life savings and laughing as she did. That is terrifying to think about. Look forward to getting to know you better. That's not a... I can't really laugh, sorry. The smile is beyond deceptive. I better watch myself around her. Oh my god, that's actually kind of fatiguing trying to remember all these people. I'm 46 minutes into the recording. So many people to get to know already. With that, all the introductions are gone. Are done. Even though they're all ultimate, they each have their own individual sort of, something. Okay, time to get down to business. This is no time to stand around making friends like a bunch of dull-eyed baboons. Oh, that's true. I think someone said something about a bigger problem or something. What was that about?
Listen.
Well, you see... Makoto, you said a bunch of stuff happened at the... and then you were just asleep, right? Well, the same is true for all of us. What, seriously?
I mean, seriously?
Just after each of us got to the main hall, we lost consciousness. Then we came to and we were somewhere here in the school. That's what happened to you, right? But that's just weird. That every one of us would get knocked out like that.
Piece of shit!
Exactly! That's why we were all freaking out. God, he's so angry about it. And that's not the only thing. You saw where all the windows in the classes always were, right? Oh yeah, they were bolted down. Instead of normal glasses windows, there's a bunch of big metal plates. What's that about?
Are you for real?
Plus, all my stuff's missing, even my cell phone. Yeah, you're right. I haven't seen my PDA anywhere, either. And then there's the main hall here. The front exit is completely blocked by some giant metal hatch.
What does this mean?
There wasn't anything like that when I first got here.
What the heck?
What is going on here?
Aww.
Maybe I got caught up in some kind of, like, you know, crime or something?
Is it, like...
Well, like a kidnapping? You think maybe someone grabbed us and hauled us off and we're not actually at school?
Hey, come on!
Come on, don't you think that? Cheer up! I bet it's so just part of the school's orientation procedure, man.
You know?
Yeah, I'm sure of it. So I'm just gonna take it easy for a little bit, bro.
I see.
Oh, so you think wants something to surprise us?
What the hell?
Huh? Well, that's all that is. It's nap time for me.
You know what I mean.
I was up way too late last night, so I could use a little shut-eye. I could feel everyone's tension evaporating. But then, it began. School started, I guess. Hello.
Ahem, ahem, testing, testing. Mic check 1, 2. This is a test of the school broadcast system.
Is that the teddy bear?
Am I on? Can everyone hear me? Okay, well then.
The voice seemed totally out of place. It was so playful, so completely unconcerned. I couldn't help but feel a deep, unnerving dread at the sound of it. It was like hearing someone laugh at the scene of an accident.
To all incoming students, I would like to begin the entrance ceremony at... right now! Please make your way to the gymnasium at your earliest convenience. That's all. I'll be waiting.
What the hell was that just now?
Goodbye.
But then, well then, if you excuse me.
Hey!
Hey, where you gonna take... What, you gonna just take off like that?
Could it be...
Oh yeah, now I get it. The whole thing was just to get us all pumped up for the entrance ceremony. Man, thank God it was all a joke. I'd be totally freaked out if it was real, bro.
You know?
Alright, guess I'll head out too. Wonder if they got planned for us next? Wonder what they got planned for us next? Damn, I was still looking forward to the snap. Why'd I have to go and kill the mood?
Huh?
Wait for me, I wanna go too. That's it then, I'll see you all there.
Anyway.
Not that anyone cares, but I'm gonna go too. Everyone took off to the gym, but I was frozen where I stood. That uneasy feeling I had before, I couldn't get it out of my mind. And it looked like I wasn't the only one. This doesn't seem right.
This is bad.
Yeah, that asthma was totally weird.
However.
Maybe, but just standing put doesn't mean we'll be safe. Besides, aren't you guys just a little bit curious to find out what's going on around here?
I see.
God, she's still with us. If we do not move forward, we learn nothing. The only choice is to push ahead. I guess she's right. But still, I'm kinda... No, really nervous. We don't have a choice. We have to go. Guess I have to go to the gym, right? Do you want to save data? Yeah. Let's go ahead and save right now. There we go. I guess we gotta head out then? Should we talk to any of them? I guess it's the only people that stay there. I guess we can exit this place. Leave the area? Yeah. Set over to the gym then. I think the gym was this way somewhere. See if we can find it. Place looks kinda cool and kinda weird at the same time. More bolted windows. There we go. The gym.
Hey guys, how's it going?
My name is Samriel.
Welcome to
Hello, what have we got here? Hello, ladies. How's it going? Breasts are the treasure of the net. I kind of want to say you could dress better.